Hi students, welcome to the online class of CPCT. Now we are going to see what is inheritance in C++. Last class we have finished up to what is a class and what is an object and what are the access specifiers in C++. Again I will repeat, there is objects are the runtime entities with the help of which you can call the member functions within the class for execution. So for each class you have to create the object. With the object and the dot operator you are calling the member functions within a class to this particular main program, and then it is actually executing. And three types of access specifiers also we have seen. That is how the data members and the member functions can be specified, how the access of that can be specified, whether it can be shown to the public, whether it can be kept as private, whether it can be kept as protected, and so on. Three ways of access specifications are there. It can be public, private, or protected. In detail, we have seen that in the last class. Now, we are going to learn what is inheritance in C++. We know that classes can be either base class or derived class. There is a parent class or the child class. Base class is otherwise known as a parent class, or it can also known as a super class. And the child class is known as a derived class or the subclass. So the child class or the derived class, which has been derived from a base class, can include, can absorb, or can inherit all the properties of the base class within it. So we have to, when we call the derived class in the main function, actually the base class also being executed. So that is what inheritance is, and that is an important property of object-oriented programming. It is also known as reusability. That is, again and again you are calling it, you are getting the characteristics of the base class within the derived class. That is a reusability, and that is what inheritance is. That is the basic concept, important basic concept in C++. Now we are going to study in this topic, in this today's class, we are going to learn what is single inheritance, what is multiple inheritance, hierarchical inheritance, multi-level inheritance, and hybrid inheritance. So again I repeat, inheritance is the ability of one class to inherit or to absorb or to include the properties of another class. Another class, this is the another class means the base class, and the new class is the derived class. Inheritance is a form of software reuse in which a new class is created by absorbing capabilities of an existing class. The existing class is called as a base class or the parent class or the super class, and the new class is called as a derived class or the subclass or the child class. Five forms of inheritance are there: single, multiple, hierarchical, multi-level, and hybrid. Hybrid is otherwise known as virtual inheritance. First, we'll see what single inheritance is. See, in this example, I have shown that two classes are there, class A and class B. Class A is a base class and class B is the derived class. That is, A is the parent and B is the child. From the parent or from the base, the derived class has been generated. So when we call the B class for execution, naturally the A class also will be executed. And here one-to-one relationship is there. That is what's written, only one class is derived from one base class. Both the classes exhibit only one. Syntax is this: class A is a base class. We'll open the bracket and write the content, and then close the curly bracket and put a semicolon. We know that always a class, when it is finished, it is being ended with a closing bracket following with a semicolon. Now let's see that we have written class B full colon access specifier A. That's the derived class. That is about the derived class. That is, a class B has been derived from class A, and is access specifier also we have to specify it over here. Because many classes will be there in a program, many parent class, many subclasses, many things will be there. So you have to specify this particular class is the child of which class. Now here it is written class B, access specifier A. That means B is the child class of, B has been derived from class A. Again open it, write the contents, close it and then end with it. So that is what single inheritance, one-to-one inheritance is there. Next is the multiple inheritance. Multiple inheritance means two parent class will, more than one parent class will be there and one derived class will be there. See this, in this clearly it has been mentioned, class A is there, B is there, they are the base classes and from that, from together joining, we got a derived class, class C. C, now C has the properties of both A and B. That is, C inherits the properties of A and B. That is, this is a feature of C++ where a class can inherit from more than one base class. Now this is the syntax, class A, curly bracket open, write the contents, curly bracket close, and then put a semicolon. That class, details about the class A is finished. Now go to the class B, again write the contents, write the member functions or the write the data members, whatever it includes, write everything and then close it and again semicolon. Now next is the derived class C. See, class C, full colon you have to put, access specifier A and access specifier B, because C has been generated, C has been derived from the parent A and parent B. So that is what mentioned here, access specifier A comma access specifier B, and then open the bracket, write the contents, close it with a. In this I'll explain with the help of an example. Normally this is an important question, inheritance is an important question in university exam. So if they will ask to write about this, you can write these examples too. So in this case, hash include iostream.h using namespace std. These are the two lines as we normally know. And then come to the class A. See this class A. Class A is the parent class. Public. See that access specifier is public. You have declared a variable x as integer. Now you are right, you have written a member function void getx. GetX is a member function where you are getting the value of x. That is, open the bracket, see out, enter the value of x, see in x, you are getting, you will get the value of x and then close it. That is what class A. Next is class B. Class B, again, in this I am getting the value of y, another constant y. That is also public. X specifier is public. Y is an integer. Void get to y. Get to y is a member function. And see out, enter the value of y, see in y. So now in class A you got the value of x and in class B you get the value of y. Now this is the derived class, class C. It has been generated from A and B. The access specifiers are public, public A and public B. So again you have to write the specification of it, the access specification of it, it is public. And here, this program is for adding the two values, which has been entered through public, through base class A and through base class B. So you got the values from there. So it inherits, class C inherited the value of contents of A and B. And then getting the value, here is the function sum, see out x plus y. So from there it will take the value of x, from B it will take the value of y, and they are added and we'll get the sum. Then comes the main function. In the main, for class C, that is the derived class only, you are creating the object. Object of the derived class, obj1, that is the object. Any name you can give over here instead of obj1, that is your wish. Now obj1 dot getx, that is what I have told. That is, with the help of the object obj1 for the class C, you have created it before, obj1 dot, dot operator also you have to include, obj1 dot getx. That means class is, function is, member function is get x, that will be executed. That is, you will get the value of x. Next is obj1.getY. Y value will get. And next is obj1.sum. That is, both of the values will be added and you will get the sum. And then return 0 and close the curly bracket. Here when output is, I have written here, enter the value of x is 5. Enter the value of y is, you have given 4. And you will get sum is 9. Next is the multi-level inheritance. Here it is shown that class A, class B and class C. Class A is the base class. Class B has been derived from class A, which is a derived class. B is the derived class, A is the base class. Now class C has been derived from the derived class B. That is written here, A and B. I have written here class B derived from base class A. And next I have written class C derived from the derived class B. It's many levels are there. Levels of communication is there. One base to one derived. And from that derived to another derived. If a class is derived from another derived class, then it is called multi-level inheritance. Now the syntax is, class A is a base class. As usual, put the bracket, write the content. Class B is the derived class. And its base class is A. So class B, full colon, access specifier A. Again its contents. Next is class C, access specifier B. That is, C's parent is the derived class B. Next, an example is there. Program to find the product of three integers. We have done it using multi-level inheritance. Hash include IO stream using namespace class A, that is the parent class, base class, public, index, getX is a member function, enter the value of x, you are getting the value of x, you are entering the value of x. Class B, parent of B is A, so about B, public is access specifier, y is the integer we are declaring there, it is as integer. And then get y is a member function, enter value of y, you are getting the value of y. And then class C. Class C's parent is B. So you have to write like this. Private. Here I have written it as private. If you need, you can put it as public. Int is that. That is a variable there. And then the member function I have marked as public. No problem. If this private also, you can make it as public. No problem. And here in this example it is okay. You can put private public over here. And then void get z, enter the value of z. So okay. Then one more member function is there to find the product. So from class A I am getting the value of x. Class B I am getting the value of y. And class z I am getting the value of z. At the same time we are multiplying x, y and z. So that is in member function product. And then comes the int main. In the int main, C is the last class, right? So for the class C, derived class C, you have created the object obj1 and then obj1.getX. With the help of the object of the class C itself, you are calling the member functions of the class A and B because C is the derived class. Here this is the importance of inheritance. That is, C is the derived class and this is actually including, this all inheriting all the properties of its parent classes. So with the object of this derived class C, that is obj1, and the dot operator dot, you are calling get x member function, get y member function and get z member function, and then return 0. Next is the hierarchical inheritance. Here, base class, only one base class and many derived classes. It is from only one parent, all the classes are being derived. Class A is there, from the class A, class B is derived, C and D are derived. So in this multiple derived classes get inherited, in this multiple derived classes get inherited from a single base class. Base class will be single and derived classes will be many. That is hierarchical inheritance. Syntax is class A, base class. Again, bracket open, close. Write the contents. Class B, access specifier of A you have to mention here. B's parent is A, C's parent is also A, and D's parent is also A. So we have written class B as a specifier A, class C as a specifier A, class D as a specifier A. That is the syntax of hierarchical inheritance. Now example for finding the product and sum of two integers. Here this is the example, class A, and here only two children are there, two derived classes are there, B and C. Based on this only I have written the program here. #include IO stream using namespace, class A is the base class, public is the access specifier. Two variables x and y, they are integers. GetData is a member function. You are entering the values of x and y, it is asking, and you are entering c in xy. So you have entered the values of x and y, and then class B, parent is A, public, there you are multiplying it. X and y you are multiplying. So that is about class B. The member function is product. And then class C, parent is A, there you are adding it. The member function is sum, x and y. You are adding x plus y. You are adding x and y. Main portion, B, for two derived classes are there here actually. A is a base class and two derived classes. So for each derived classes, you have to create each object, individual objects. That is for B, you have created the object OBJ1, and C, you have created the object OBJ2. So with the help of OBJ1, you are getting the data of X and Y, that is OBJ1 dot X, get data, and then OBJ1 dot product. You are multiplying it and you are getting it. And then with the help of OBJ2, so you come to class, derived class C, OBJ2, get data, and OBJ2, sum. And then return 0, example is written here, and the value of X and Y, 2, 3 you have entered, product is equal to 6. Again enter the value, because 2 times you have given. For OBJ1, get data you have given. For OBJ2 also, get data you have given. So 2 times values it is asking. If you need, you can give different values, 2, 3, and then sum is equal to 5. Next is the hybrid inheritance. Hybrid inheritance is the combination of all other inheritances. Single will be there, multiple, multi-level, hierarchical inheritances will be there. So in this, class A is deriving class B, and then B and C, you are getting class D. Combination of two or more inheritance, that is hybrid inheritance. Now here also the syntax, class A, class B's parent is class A, class C is individual class, class D again, from B and C, we are getting class D. So class D, access specifier B, access specifier C. Same syntax, no difference. Just check who is the parent of which class. Make it confirmed. And then write about the base class and then go for the child of it. Mention it. From where it has been derived. Yes, that is enough. If two parents are there, means two access specifiers, two classes, two base classes names you have to specify. Here also example, to find sum of two integers, namespace std, class A, public index, public, B is the child class, derived class, B's parent is A, and here I have written public, the member function is actually constructor, that is the name of the class and the name of the member function will be same, that is a constructor, constructor to initialize X. Here you have initialized the value of x, so x value is 10, and then class C. Class C is another class, that is also a base class, so no parent class specification is there. So class C, open the bracket, public int y, there you are getting the value of y, and here C is also again a constructor. See this, class name is C, and the member function name is also C, that means it is a constructor. And then class D, parent of D is B and C. So mention it there. And then there we are finding the sum. Void sum. C out sum is equal to X plus Y. Then comes to the main. Int main D. D is the last class. Last derived class. So only one object is needed. So for class D, OBJ1. OBJ1 dot sum. So when that sum is called, everything will come. And then return 0 and close the curly bracket. That is about hierarchical inheritance. This class we have learned about what is inheritance, what is the importance of inheritance, and what are the different forms of inheritances. Now, thank you, dear students. Next class, we'll continue with the next topic.